I used to eat lust and drink pride. That was my diet. Now, I'm not going to hide my old true colors, you know, diet. To be blunt, I wasn't private about my private. I looked for a QT, forget the S, because I would say R if I didn't get that chest treasure like a pirate. Speaking of letters, call me a B, because I was looking for a honey to jive. Not on that black and yellow, but it's a miracle that I didn't get the hive. I mapped, looking for an apple bottom to dive. Praise Jesus for saving me. Now I got my hand up like I'm giving God a high five. I used to go by Andy, strictly looking for the eye candy, trying to find a girl that was dandy that I could call to come in handy. I thought I was a macho man like Randy. I was just John Travolta looking for my Sandy, but not only for summer loving at the beach when it's sandy, but anytime when it came to girls, I wanted more like Mandy, asking myself, have you ever liked Brandy? When I wasn't lusting, I was having withdrawals. Chilling with the girl, you'd rarely see me withdrawals, because I was trying to make a deposit opposite of withdrawals. I was walking, turning, and shooting my life away like they do withdrawals. But I was naive and was taken advantage of once by church leadership. We all fall short to the glory of God, but I fell for the leader's hip. But I'm no better, though. I've tempted others on Skype, FaceTime, and other social media. Was young and foolish, thinking every day was my day, like me, Dia. I call a girl beautiful, but to be truthful, I just looked to see if she had a booty pool. What can I say, that I was youthful? That's inexcusable. To Jesus, that's unsuitable. We need to treat sin like it was a virus and that Bible was our pharmaceutical. I struggled to find a date. Nike said just do it, but the Bible said to wait. I just wanted someone who I could relate. Instead, I heard Andrew. I'm real late. Talk about a high heart rate. Though I carried the protection, like the number after 8. No KY. Ironically, that's where I live in my state. I just wanted a mate, but the whole time I just needed to walk the narrow and straight. Now, I know I'm giving it to you raw like the rare steak, but I'm a youth pastor, so I know what's at stake. People are one left click away from a mistake. Those videos always look perfect because they never show you that mistake. See, I lost someone who was pure to a driver driving drunk. I wanted to get away from everyone in isolation like a monk. But that's when Satan tempted me the worst with an easy score like a dunk. And I failed over and over. I felt like I was born a flunk. But that's when I realized that our God is so approachable. We need to remain humble so that we can be coachable. Philippians 1:21, to live as Christ, to die as gain, that's a non-negotiable. And we need to stop justifying our sins like, God, I was just trying to be sociable. But I feel like a hypocrite even rapping this. Because lust has always been a struggle, and I ain't talking about just the kiss. Because that woman will never hit and fill the hole in your heart. That's why we call them miss. It's a secret sin in most guys' life, but we portray like we're a holy like Swiss. Lust is a word that no one can trust. For letters in a church that's rarely discussed. Well, God looks on in disgust. We must fight against it or we'll be dirtier than rust. Sexual impurities enter my mind from Pepe Le Pew. While I was lusting on Friday nights, I was lying in that Sunday morning pew. Conviction didn't hit my heart, and so I slowly grew into a child of darkness because I never knew. Lusting sexually will only cause danger. My hormones were morphing mightily as I used to crush on that pink ranger. I lust after anyone, even a complete stranger. I heard the story, but I never understood of the one born in a manger. Even as I got older, I didn't quite get it. I never knew that in my mother's womb, he knit it. I used Jesus' name for my glory, I'll admit it. I've used and abused many women, I'll never forget it. I pray God will restore their hearts and bring them healing. I'm being honest, forgive me if I'm too revealing. But that was my old way, now I'm kneeling. Praising him for his forgiveness, hands raised to the ceiling. Praise God that he forgives and makes us clean. Before his throne, we'll be speechless. Mr. Bean, I'm just a student and he's the principal or the dean. Lust has been a dominant gene to make me want to drop a gene. Treat him like an object and not a queen. Was this way since I was 13, but now he changed me, so praise Elohim. Lust took over and high. I needed him the most high, but I settled for my sexual cravings. Down goes the fly. Never had accountability. Still thought I was a good guy. There was a hole in my heart. We can call it a gap. Filled with ladies, if you couldn't already tell from this rap. They revealed their bodies like an open map, but I felt captured by their frame. Picture that, a booby trap. Now, this is just a chapter of my own personal biography. I can tell you the humps on a woman's body and label it geography. But don't you dare laugh, because I just admitted to the struggle of pornography that started in the sixth grade when I saw that first photography. Father, I need you. This fight is so hard. Every sin that I commit makes me think of your scars. It breaks me down and puts me on my knees. Lord, take away this temptation, please. Feeling so sick, just like a disease. I have a fever, it's only 60 degrees. A constant battle of what my eye sees. I start lusting, my heart is bitten like fleas. Why they be feeling the need to tease? Women wearing skirts up above your knees, putting it out there and thinking it's hot. Ladies, hear me right now, it's not. Y'all are just caught in a filthy knot. The media says drink, have sex, and smoke pot, but the Lord is the one who gave you what you got to respect yourself. He loves you a lot. Lust, temptation, rotten the mind of this generation. Being single is good for debating. Yeah, there's fish, but are they worth baiting? It's 3 a.m., what you texting me for? Saying you got some fun in store. Creep in the night and open the door. I'm feeling the flames like never before. Call yourself Dora, you want to explore. I'll be hurting just like before. These are the things that I got to ignore, so my life will be centered with Christ at the core. Friend of God, James 4:4. All my knees, I'm ready for war. Fight for life like I'm in the core to battle this lust with the word of the Lord. Yo, the Bible is our sword. If he or she ain't living for Christ, then it's better to get back to the drawing board. Us slipping into temptation gets Satan bored. His demons tempt you on, saying, look at what you scored. But Christ offers freedom like an extension of cord. A sexually lustful mentality thinks of fusion like a Ford. Let Christ in your heart for real fusion and claim Jesus is Lord. Praise him that I got a godly wife, you see. She's forgiven me of my past, which amazes me. I see Christ through her, call it transparency. I'm so thankful that I popped the question on my knee. Our relationship grew at Northern. Go North. We stayed away from the dark side and used the force. We got married and continue to seek Jesus as our source, because we know Satan is prowling and wants a divorce. The world says do what you want and let nature take its course, but we can't just drop out of a relationship like a college course, even if it's hard to understand, like someone who is hoarse. He or she may tee you off and may not be up to par, of course, but the grass isn't always greener, like a golf course. Now, lust has almost ended our relationship a couple times. I could go on and tell you how in these rhymes. I encourage you men to go after a God-fearing lady, regardless of the dimes, because it doesn't make much sense anyway, like talking mimes. Because some ladies can make a lot of noise, but be gone with the wind like chimes. They don't realize if it's your hearts, they're guilty of committing crimes. But you're guilty yourself, because you're selfish at times. So it's a constant battle, like not trying to close your eyes while eating lemons and limes. People say they don't believe in Jesus because there's no proof. He took my addiction to sexual morality away, gone poof. Yeah, I can be a goof, but this ain't a spoof. I'm praising him with two hands in the air, you think I was raising the roof. Now, I'm sure in the past you've never stolen offense, so there's no need now for you to take offense. I'm no longer lukewarm, you know, on defense, because I got my mind focused in the zone as my defense. Bishop, check out that chick. Yeah, I saw, bro, you need to cut off the flesh like an eye saw. God can change you like he did Paul. Change his heart and said, don't lie, Saul. That's why I'm trying to disinfect my sin like I'm spraying a can of Lysol. Don't fall for that perfume. If you do, you may be part of the next baby boom. From the womb, we were doomed, born sinners even before we begin to bloom. Let God make your dead body walk like Christ did when he walked out of that tomb.